think a lot went through our mind other than we need to get down there right now and start searching for the victims.
Sam Conger and his two sons, Lucas and Cameron, were in the middle of an advanced class for recreational snowmobilers on Saturday when they came across a backcountry explorer's worst nightmare.
They were at the front of the group and they radioed right away that there was someone in the debris.
The class of nine being taught by Mike Duffy, an avalanche instructor, knew in that moment they had to do everything they could to try and help.
They didn't hesitate to get in the water. They wanted to save a life.
But Duffy explains this avalanche had some extra challenges. With the mountain right on Pump House Lake, the avalanche's weight causing the snow to crack the ice.
And then the water seeps through, and then it gets deeper during the rescue, and it starts saturating the snow. And at some points, it was thigh deep. They had to get into the water to get the person.
The whole class switching their personal beacons into search mode and were able to find the first victim within a minute.
But being waterlogged, it was pretty exhausting 7 minutes for everybody involved that was trying to free this man.
At the same time, others were spot probing for the second victim who wasn't wearing a transponder.
But the avalanche debris was so deep that our probes couldn't even reach the ground in some spots.
The two snowmobilers, both recovered by Grand County Search and Rescue, were friends and next-door neighbors in Loveland. It was 58-year-old Bruce DeYoung and 52-year-old Darren Kaderka. They are now being remembered by family and friends as two guys who loved to go snowmobiling. Courtney Fromm, Fox 31.